Welcome back to Jay vs. Horror. I'm Jay Wall, and today, guys, we're going to be talking about the top 10 horror films of 2013. Now, this is our 13th episode in this series on our way to name the top 10 films of the last two decades. So let's get started. At number 10, we have Frankenstein's Army. It's a Dutch-American-Czech found footage horror film directed by Richard Raphorst. Written by Chris Mitchell and Miguel Tejada Flores, it stars Carol Roden and Joshua Sazi. In the film, Soviet troops invading Germany encounter undead mechanical soldiers created by a mad scientist descended from the one and only Victor Frankenstein. I know there's a lot of people out there that just hate found footage movies in general, but I always tell them you gotta dig through the piles to find the gems, and guys, this is one of the gems. Now, there's also a lot of horror hoodwinkers out there. Self-published authors and terrible filmmakers. People who put out things like Dracula's Daughter or Frankenstein's Maid. What they're really doing is just taking a product that horror fans are familiar with and repackaging it. This film is different. It's creative, it's original, it has great monsters and great gore. So let's take a look at the trailer for Frankenstein's Army.
Not far. If we get a move on, we can be there by noon.
Do you see anything?
Come on!
Let's move down to the church. What is that?
What are you? Only the Nazis would think of something like this. Throwing dead people together. Giving them knives for hands. It's insane.
Come in. Oh, don't be shy. Simple mechanics, engineering. Each one is still alive.
A man of vision is always misunderstood.
At number 9, I have Texas Chainsaw 3D. It's an American slasher horror film directed by John Luzinop with a screenplay by Adam Marcus, Deborah Sullivan, and Kirsten Elms. It is the 7th installment in the Texas Chainsaw Massacre franchise and was presented originally in 3D. The film serves as a direct sequel to the 1974 film, and it stars Alexandria Daddario, Dan Yeager, Trey Songz, Scott Eastwood, and of course, Bill Moseley, with credits given to Marilyn Burns and Gunnar Hansen from the original 1974 film. Guys, this one gets a lot of hate out there, and I truly don't understand it. This franchise doesn't have a lot of continuity, because every 10 years or so, they tried to restart it, and they would take up a whole new approach. This time, they present Leatherface as kind of an anti-hero, which I enjoyed. We see a distant cousin, played by Alexandria Daddario, inherit the old Sawyer house and with it all its secrets, including a room in the basement which houses Leatherface. I enjoyed it a lot, and I would have loved to see them keep on with this storyline. Seeing Leatherface as an anti-hero is fun because you don't have to feel bad about anybody that he kills. We could have even had a sequel where the cousin invites all these pedophiles and rapists and criminals to the big house, locks the gates, and just lets Big Cuz have some fun. Let's take a look at the trailer for Texas Chainsaw 3D.
Mm-hmm.
east in me.
So do you know anything about this place? Just the address.
It's caged by frail and fragile bars.
Wow.
Restless by day and by night, rants and rages.
Look like Granny likes to play a little pool.
What exactly did Granny do for a living?
I have no idea. I just learned about her yesterday.
The beast in me. God help the beast in me.
At number 8, we have Dark Skies, an American science fiction horror film written and directed by Scott Stewart and produced by Jason Blum. It stars Kerry Russell, Josh Hamilton, Dakota Goyo, and J.K. Simmons. A very interesting film that follows a family plagued by alien abduction. Or are they? While the movie leaves us with many questions, it proves to be well worth the watch. So let's take a look at the trailer for Dark Skies.
Hey, we got people coming over in 5. Get your butt home. An epic game of modern warfare.
Yeah, that's what save buttons are for, pal.
Himself before he came to my room.
There's no sign of forced entry. Sure all the doors and windows were locked?
I'm sure. We check them every night.
Karen says you guys had to call the police. Is everything all right at home?
Yeah.
It's as if something was drawing them to your home.
Something's going on.
What are we talking about?
I don't know. I can't explain it.
Sammy, come here. Let me take a look at you.
The marks on your son's body appear to have been applied with a brand.
There are people who have reported experiencing the same things that we have been experiencing. I found a guy who claims to be an expert on this stuff.
Have you experienced any unexplained illnesses or blackouts?
Daniel, why aren't you answering me? Daniel!
Feeling that you might not be in control of your own body?
There's something wrong with you people!
You cannot escape them. Sooner or later,
us alone!
At number 7, we have a very little known film titled Avenged, also known as Savaged. It's a rape revenge horror film directed by Michael S. Ojeda. The film premiered October 15, 2013, and stars Amanda Adrian as a beautiful young deaf-mute woman who is brutalized by a group of local rednecks. Afterwards, her body is inhabited by the spirit of a Native American warrior who has also been wronged. And from here, we see her set out on a bloody trail of revenge and violence. Let's take a look at the trailer for Avenged.
Come live with me. Be with me.
Have you seen the American Southwest? It's vast, desolate, and there's a lot of crazies out there. Just promise me.
Be with me.
Zoe, I'm still not convinced this is a good idea. You'll be alone.
I'll be okay.
Wait.
Please, don't let them take me.
Excuse me. My fiance passed through town a couple of days ago.
That pet of yours.
Tough.
Now, that is a knife.
This is like tying up a piggy.
Just your top, too.
What kind of sick mind game are you all playing?
No game.
You hear about that deaf mute gone missing?
Yeah. Come on.
Holy Mother of God. Skilled. Lethal. Being controlled like a puppet.
Unnatural or not, we all got...
You were in the company of the great Apache chief. You became one.
A bloodshed will not cease until the last is dead.
Unnatural or not, we all got targets on our asses.
We're getting ready to take a big leap. Get married.
You okay?
The time to
say! Baby, give him hell! Nine little Indian.
At number 6, we have Carrie. An American supernatural horror drama film directed by Kimberly Pierce. It is the third film adaptation of Stephen King's 1974 novel of the same name and the fourth film overall in the Carrie franchise. The film was produced by Kevin Mischer with a screenplay by Lawrence Cohen and stars Chloe Grace Moretz as the titular character, Carrie White. Now, I know many of you aren't fans of remakes and reboots and things like that, guys, but for me, I'm about to commit a horror sin here and tell you that I like this film better than the original. Anchored by a great performance from Chloe Grace Moretz and a superb supporting outing for Julianne Moore, let's take a look at the trailer for Carrie.
This was always such a peaceful town.
I don't want to use the word conspiracy, but that's what it's looking like.
Her mother was a fanatic. I don't know how she lived with her.
To believe something supernatural happened here defies logic and explanation.
There's one thing no one seems to understand. She wasn't some monster. She's just a girl.
Say,
number 5 for 2013, we have World War Z, an American apocalyptic action horror film directed by Mark Forster, with a screenplay by Matthew Michael Carnahan, Drew Goddard, and Damon Lindelof. The film is based on the 2006 novel of the same name by Max Brooks. It stars Brad Pitt as Jerry Lane, a former United Nations investigator who must travel the world to find a way to stop a zombie pandemic. And let's be honest here, horror fans, this film doesn't do much that many other films in the zombie subgenre have already done, but it does them on a much larger scale with a much bigger budget. I'm a fan of the way they show the countdown here as someone gets bit and then turns. The film also has some great effects and gives us some epic scenes of zombie hordes and gives us another great performance from Brad Pitt. Guys, let's take a look at the trailer for World War Z.
Does it live in a jungle?
No. Oh.
Is it really fast?
No.
Does it live on the Great Plains of Africa?
No. Hey!
What is going on?
Hold on, guys.
Daddy, be careful on the road. Jerry?
Get back in your car right now! Remain with your feet!
What is this?
It's the scene worldwide. Is anyone doing better than we are?
We don't know.
I'm scared.
How do we know they're coming?
They're coming. Ready?
Go, go, go!
Come on.
I need you to help him.
You're asking me to leave my family.
I'm not gonna force you.
Don't pretend you're not well suited for the job.
Baby?
Tell the kids I'm coming back.
Honey!
Just know, I'm coming back.
At number 4, we have Mama, a supernatural horror film directed and co-written by Andy Muschietti in his directorial debut, and the film is based on his 2008 Argentine short film, also titled Mama. The film stars Jessica Chastain and Nicolje Coster-Waldau. The film follows two young girls abandoned in a forest cabin and fostered by an unknown entity that they fondly refer to as Mama, which eventually follows them to their new suburban home after their uncle comes to retrieve them. I love this film, guys, even though I did find the ending to be a little lacking. Director Andy Muschietti makes his bones here before going on to direct It and It Chapter 2. A very strong entry to this list. Let's take a look at the trailer for Mama.
Victoria and Lily were found in deplorable conditions. Their parents gone. Alone in the wilderness for at least 5 years.
Hey, Victoria.
How they survived is unexplainable.
I'm your daddy's brother. Remember, Uncle Luke?
with a loving family environment.
Victoria and Lily have a real chance at a normal life.
You sure about this?
Nope.
Hey, girls.
Mama. I'm Annabelle. You can call me that. Or whatever you like.
Mama. There's no way these girls are ready for this. And there is no way that I am ready for this.
How have they been affected?
They talk to the wolves.
And what do they say?
Mama.
It'll get better.
Like that?
I'd like you to tell me about Mama.
No. What's wrong? I don't want you to get hurt. Nothing bad's gonna happen to me. You can't do that.
Condemned to repeat itself time and time again.
Where is she now? Is she here in this house?
Mama, stop it! You promised! Who is Mama Victoria?
At number three, guys, we have VHS 2, a horror anthology film produced by Bloody Disgusting as a sequel to the original VHS. It comprises five found footage segments linked together by a framed narrative. This time out, we get a new batch of up-and-coming directors, including Jason Eisner, Gareth Evans, Timo Tajajanto, Eduardo Sanchez, Greg Hale, and, of course, franchise returnees Simon Barrett and Adam Wingard. Most horror fans consider this to be the strongest of the VHS trilogy. So let's take a look at the trailer for VHS 2.
So what's the deal now?
Just this woman thinks her son is missing.
Doesn't look like anyone's home. Here, look at this.
These tapes only affect you if you play it at a correct sequence.
Number two, we have Evil Dead, an American supernatural horror film directed by Fede Alvarez in his feature directorial debut. Written by Roto Sayagas and Alvarez and produced by Robert Tappert, Sam Raimi, and Bruce Campbell, this is the fourth installment in the Evil Dead franchise. It serves as a soft reboot and continuation of the original series. The film stars Jane Levy, Shiloh Fernandez, Lou Taylor Pucci, Jessica Lucas, and Elizabeth Blackmore. Now guys, it's very unusual for me to have a remake or a reboot this high on any list, but this one's damn good. Let's take a look at the trailer for Evil Dead.
Evil Dead, rated R.
At number one for 2013, guys, I have The Conjuring. It's an American supernatural horror film directed by James Wan and written by Chad and Carrie Hayes. It is the inaugural film in the Conjuring Universe franchise and stars Patrick Wilson along with Vera Farmiga as Ed and Lorraine Warren, paranormal investigators and authors associated with prominent cases of hauntings. Here we see the Warrens come to the assistance of the Perrone family, who experienced increasingly disturbing events at their farmhouse in Rhode Island during the year of 1971. For me, guys, The Conjuring is not only a great horror film, it's just simply a great American film, period. It takes me back to days of films like The Amityville Horror and The Entity and other great films like that. So without further ado, let's take a look at the trailer for The Conjuring.
I get my own room.
Oh, you can't be here.
Let me try with pleasure at hand.
Clap. I'm gonna get you now. I can hear you breathing.
You took your blindfold off. I win. I was in Christine and Nancy's room.
Girls, it's way past your bedtime.
Alright, horror fans, that's all we've got for 2013. Now, to be honest, this was a pretty lean year for horror films. Overall, though, I think we made some good choices. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we will talk to you the next time we've got something worth talking about. Bye.